Now, as I mentioned in my book, you got to set yourself up for success and not failure. We just happen to be doing this in 90 plus degree heat, which is tough on me and it's tough on the horse. Now, when I fully intend to go for a good join up, I don't want to put that much physiological stress on the horse, and certainly not on myself. We're not out here to have a heat stroke. We're out here to work on our respect issues. So I can go for a marginal join up, which means marginal means I don't get the licking and chewing, but I've certainly invested a lot of time in this horse, getting her to move her feet to yield her space to me, and that's very dominant in her language. I don't want her to be afraid of me. I want her to know that coming into me is a comfortable place to be and a safe place to be, but I also don't want her or me to get heat stroke, so I may stop this a little early before we get the head lowering and the licking and chewing. I'm going to go back to her other side. I'm going to make her change direction. It's my idea to change direction, not hers. Here we go. Back to the original side. Doesn't go to the corners because she's seen this before from this side. So it's something she's familiar with. That inside ear is staying locked on me. She's given up pretty much on trying to find a way out of here. So she's dealing with me, which is what we want. There's licking and chewing. Very little bit of it. But in this heat, I'm going to go passive and walk away from her and see what happens. Nothing. I don't feel anything. So I'm going to come into her. Solid eye contact. She looks at me. Try to draw her in. That didn't work. Try it again. She's got herself up against the fence here. There's no place for her to go. She's turning her head away. Okay, that didn't work. So she doesn't make any attempt to join up. So we send her around again. Let her know that that was not acceptable. I want her to at least turn and face me. And when they won't do that, what I did by going in on her, pushing my eye pressure onto hers, wanted to make her turn away. Which was a submissive move on her part. Now she's back in that corner. She just wants to get away from this. There we go. There we go. It's all right. Here we go. And I'm going to stop her down in a place where she's not so confined. I'm just taking the eye pressure off. As soon as I stop pushing, she quits. Now she's standing with her back to me. I don't like that. There's the look. You're right in the camera, kid. Yep, come on. There, she turned. It's okay. Okay, that's the right thing to do. That's the right thing. Come on. Here we come. That's a step or two. I'm going to try again. I'm going to roll my shoulder by her. I'm up in this corner where the camera can't see me. That's wonderful. Here we go. Licking and chewing. I can hear it. Good girl. Oh, easy now. Easy now. Easy now. Easy now. You did the right thing. Good girl. Good girl. No eye contact. Give her a good rub. She's head shy. It's all right. It's all right. Come on, walk with me. Come on, walk with me. Walk on. All right, we'll try it this way. Walk on. Come on. that was absolute minimal. I'm going to try to bring her in again. Yeah. Yeah. Look at the eyeball goobers you got. Come on. Come on. Yeah, well, she's facing me. That's good. Good girl. It's all right. It's all right. Come on. Come on. Now she's distracted. She's down eating the dirt. All right, I'm going to leave it at that because it's so hot. I did get her trussed. She's still pretty leery. This is the one you sized? Okay. Yeah. Let's see if I've got enough truss to get the halter on her. Yeah. I'm not looking directly at her. I'm just coming up to her. Let me pet you, honey. That's a girl. Good girl. It's all right. It's all right. It's all right. All right. We're going to have a problem then. You're going to have to go back to work. You're going to have to go back to work. Yeah. Yeah. Get out of the corner. Get out of the corner. Go on. Get. Make the right thing easy and the wrong thing difficult. Now, I'm not just lunging her as a reprimand. I'm also trying to convince her that coming in here and standing by me is a lot easier than turning her back to me and walking away. Ah, get. Push a little bit more adrenaline through her. I'm going to stop her down. Nope, she went into the corner. I don't want that. Get out of the corner. Get out of the corner. Get out of the corner. Go on. That's it. Okay. All right, let me stop for a second. She's on autopilot. She's going back in that corner. Nope, didn't change direction. Doesn't make any difference. She's already figured out she can't get out of here. That horse isn't helping her. When you first start out, yeah, but the distraction is okay. You need some distraction. It's better to start out when you're first doing it with a horse. That's join up, I mean. It's better to do it where they cannot see the other horses. It takes a little bit more time to do it because you've got to push them past that point of trying to get to the other horses for safety. They have to realize that coming to you is the safety zone. But once you push them past that, when they stop hiding in the corners, when you get that inside ear locked on you, they have already gone past the point of being worried about the other horses. But to answer your question, yes, it's better to do it when the other horses aren't in close proximity and can't come over to visit. So you basically have to put the horses up. Okay? I'm going to take the pressure off.